In this video, we're going to take a short list of employees and we're going to compare it to a larger employee database. And we want to find that list of employees in that larger employee database. And whenever we find a matching employee, we want to highlight the entire row. We're going to do that using the match formula in Excel, as well as a special formula for conditional formatting. Let's take a look. Here we have our list of employees that we're tracking, and maybe this is a list of employees who have already completed their timesheet for the week. So we want to compare this to our main employee database list and then highlight these on the main employee database. So I'm just going to go and use the side-by-side view here just so I can show you. Here we have the short list, and then over here we have our long list of our employee database that we want to find all of these employees on this main list and highlight them. So we're going to do that using the match formula. So let me go ahead and expand this so we can see it. And I'm going to insert a column here by clicking on column B and right click and select insert. And this is going to be a column where we're going to use our match formula. So I'm just going to call this find match. And we'll make it a different color so we know this is where we put our formula. And all we're going to do is type equals match, open parentheses, and now we're going to look up value. I know that on both of these sheets, I have employee ID number that I can use as a lookup value. If you don't have an employee ID number, if you have another unique value that's on both sheets that you can use to compare, like a work email, you can use that to look up on. But I'm going to select the cell that has the employee ID as my lookup value, and then I hit comma. And now I want to select the array. So this is going to be the list of employees that I'm tracking that I want to find. So I'm going to go over to that list and I'm going to select the whole column. You can select the whole column or just the range, but I'm going to go ahead and select the column. And so over here, that gives us automatically Excel has put the dollar signs around that column, and that anchors or fixes that range so it won't shift when we drag the formula down on the other side. So we're going to leave that like it is, and then we're going to come over here and we're going to type a comma, and then we want an exact match, so we're going to type 0 for an exact match, and then close our parentheses and hit enter. And notice over here on our main database, we have a hashtag NA. And so that means that this employee record was not found to be a match on our other list. So all we have to do now is copy this formula down. So I'm going to bring my cursor over here to the bottom right corner till it turns into crosshairs and double click. And that will copy the match formula all the way down on the spreadsheet. So notice that if it does not find a match, it'll show a hashtag NA. If it finds a match, it's going to display a number. And what this number is actually the row number of where it found that employee's record on the other sheet. So for example, we've got down here, Pierre Despereau, number 5. If we go and look at that other sheet, we see that Pierre Despereau is on the 5th row of that spreadsheet. So that is what the match formula is returning. It's returning a number, the number of the row where it found the match. So now what we want to do is I want to turn this, instead of having it return either an NA or a number, I want it to return true or false. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to the formula, and right after the equals, I'm going to type isNumber. And I'm going to open a parenthesis and then put another closed parenthesis at the end. And this wraps the match formula inside the isNumber formula. And when I hit enter, you're going to see that it will say false. And so now if I select this and copy it down, double click to copy down, now it'll show true or false, depending on if it found the match. So now there's a couple ways that we can highlight the values that are true. We can always select the column and on the Home tab, come over to Conditional Formatting. We can select the Highlight Cells rule and we can say text that contains, and then we want to type in here true, so anything that's true, and then we can select, you know, maybe a yellow fill and click OK, and it will highlight any true value. But if we want to highlight the entire row, there is a different conditional formatting rule that you can apply. So I'm going to go ahead and let's go ahead and clear that out. I'm going to go back to conditional formatting, say clear rules from the entire sheet. And so now what I want to do is I want to actually select just below the header, I want to select all of the data in here. So I can select one row across from A through G and then hit Control Shift down. And this will select all of the data that's in the sheet that I want to apply this conditional formatting rule to. And then I can come up to the Home tab, go to Conditional Formatting, and click on New Rule. From here, you're going to say use a formula to determine which cells to format. And then in here is where we're going to type this rule. And what we're going to say is equals, and then search. And then we're going to open a parenthesis, and we're going to put in quotes true, because we want to find, it's searching for the word true, and if it finds it in that row, we want it to be highlighted. So we're searching that. So then we're going to put comma, and then we are going to concatenate or list out the rows that we want to apply this highlighted format to. So to do that, we're going to say $A2, and then we're going to put the ampersand, and then do that the same for all of the columns that we want to highlight. So the next one will be B2, so we're going to say $B2, ampersand, $C2, ampersand, $D2, ampersand, $E2, ampersand, $F2, ampersand, $G2. And then we're going to close the parentheses. And now we're going to come over here to the Format tab. We're going to select that and come over here. If it's on number, come over to the fill area. And let's just highlight this in bright yellow so we can see it easily. You can select any color. If you want to highlight just the fill color of that row, you can select the color and then click OK. And now we're going to click on OK. And now we can see that anywhere that there is a true value, the entire row is highlighted in yellow. So that is how you can find a match from another spreadsheet and then highlight the entire row of those found employees. Now, one thing I will recommend or caution with conditional formatting is notice that conditional formatting formats this in the background. So if I were to come out here and try to, say, change the fill color on this cell, it's not gonna let me. You know, it's conditionally formatted, so I can't easily come out and change the formatting on that. I would have to actually select that area, come out to conditional formatting, and clear the rule either on the selected cell or from the entire sheet. And so a different way of doing this, if you didn't want to use the conditional formatting because of that reason, maybe you want to come back and change the highlighting or do different things on your spreadsheet. Another thing you could do, I'm going to come down here and copy my database so that I can show you what to do. I'll just say move a copy on the end and then create a copy and click OK. And so here I'm going to go ahead and select the whole sheet and remove the rules from this sheet. And then this was the color that I had selected behind the scenes. So I'm going to unfill that color. And so now if I just want to myself highlight these, all I have to do is come up to Data and go to Filter. And then I can filter on just my true values, click OK. And then I can just select those, come back to the Home tab, select my fill color, highlight those, and you can always go back to your data area and clear the formatting. And then you have all of your trues highlighted as well. And then if you wanted to come and make a change to that formatting, then you can come out and do that, and you're able to make a change on your formatting. So there are a couple of different ways that you can highlight those values that you find. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up. To like it, you can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.